Hello, welcome to our third. Yeah, let's go back. Number three vlog. It's still laggy, just left though. But still laggy, currently. Anyway, for the pairing, to start off, we have Game Night, written by Joshua Hewitt. No, Jason Bateman had nothing to do with this one. Okay, got this joke out of the way. As time implying, Milo got to look up, tried to have COVID game night, particularly, a board game, because Milo actually never finished one before, because Murphy lost. So, I'm trying to play a board game to see if I can finish it, and other characters could have come in and joined the game, as things go along, like Kara and Neil from the comic shop, back, and Mom and Dad, and I think Eklay from there. I really liked the one. I've enjoyed the one so far, but this one I really liked a lot. I mean, it does fall into a typical format of the show, where they try to do something very gone away. And of course, much like a family vacation, there's more about sticking together and, the fun part, and, it matters, go perfectly. And it just dug it really well. I mean, it can go really fun episode of exclamation, where you just get creative thing going along, take a lot of good jokes. It's fun to keep certain characters, like a Veronica. So, making a cameo, she can join in on the game, but she gets an appearance. To go and cameos show up, and Rapont, they're gonna actually move forward. Apparently, we joined them, they're doing something involving, like, a black hole that we don't get to know what that's all about. Like, they appear, they do something, but they, the two outco them go far, and then that go for and Rapont, and the coin duckins, but I appreciate that, because it allows them to do something outside of their plot line. And I quite enjoy that. A lot of fun character moments, but I don't get some decent moments. We get our first song of Keegan, not counting in the clock over that I might remember, because it's like a metal song about game night. I enjoy that a fair bit. Go. There's a lot of really fun stuff, and of course they have that quirky element there. That didn't work, again, got more 2-hour episode, but it didn't work. Like, if we kept episode, I kind of knew from the premise that it could be a fun one, but it seemed like they really took advantage of the premise of it being a board game. So we kind of build on, leading to a pretty funny ending. I really like this one. I don't know if it's very good or great, but definitely a really good episode. I forgot I liked even more in the crop. I can't think of my favorite thing so far. But anyway, it was a lot of fun and a very nice episode. A good use of character. Again, both Neil and Veronica get to appear again. And I appreciate it. So, yeah, Game Night, quite a good episode. On to the next one. Paint Make Wait, written by Jim Bernstein. Not much to get out of one. Milo goes to the pink car thing where they're doing the great for Sherry to make money for Llama. And while he's there, he bumped him to Elliot. But they want to ride in the safety car because the project going on and the winner gets to be in the safety car. And of course, he and Elliot go, he wants to be in there. But Milo wins instead. But Milo, Elliot again, trying to, let him ride with him, let Elliot ride with Milo. Go away, ride in the safety car. But of course, bursting off, go wrong. No, I should get for the one. It got that night key Elliot have gone good happen to him. Especially after my dreams, but get good. No, that happened to him. He's a complete white safety. And they recognize that, so. Pretty typical episode, and they do something, perfect law, but plenty of fun things. We're calling this one, we're kind of calling it each episode, before I know it. We're calling here, kind of forgettable kind, but a little catchy, okay, to come. Go, get better, go the other one. Elliot calling great, we get the little joke, it being a llama, they're trying to go in, Llama can't come, except for this one. joke like that. The ending joke is one that could have ruined the plot, but I feel like the way it executed and making it still work. So, yeah, quite the typical episode, but even though typical episode show or have enough of that humor and charm to make up for it, the Dodecon encounters in the form of plot progression, we're playing that on hold for a moment. There are other episodes, we got all the episodes that we go for in English from the UK. I'm caught up now. There's been a bunch of they appear in Spain and such, but I can't understand what they're saying, so no point in watching them. So I'm going away from the UK, and it seems like by the time you see this, they'll be airing in the US, so it doesn't matter. When I record things, they're all going to come out in time, hopefully. But yeah. Compared to Penguin, pretty simple. It's fun. It's nice to get yelling. It's going to happen. Yeah. But Gay Night is where it got. That's the one where I really like that one a lot. But still, this one was fun too. I don't have any, issue here. We've been on the roll of pulling out a fun episode. Just come have added more caveats in there. But Gay Night are kind of like, this is more of what I want to see. They're going to be up to a few things, but. It's all been fun, but these one in particular were especially entertaining. I have no idea what book to even next one book to get. I actually have no idea. Next one, fun one coming up. I don't know. Again, I'll find out when I do a vlog. I'm not wasting a lot of time. Here we go. Fun. That's going especially Game Night. Best one so far. New for whatever that's going to turn out to be.